Hey guys, so I know you saw the title and you were like, oh no, not another one of those like TikTok videos that makes me feel super horrible about my own life. Don't worry, this is not one of those videos. This is basically a take on that, calling all of that girl stuff kind of bullshit and saying, you know what, actually, it's about taking care of yourself and really putting your mental health first. Like, I'm gonna be honest with you guys, I've really been struggling with my mental health like throughout the pandemic and just being back at school, so I just wanted to share these tips because I think it's something that all of us really struggle with, and doing little things like waking up in the morning and moving my body first thing, like it doesn't have to be crazy early. I try to wake up early and get going at least once a week because for me it just helps me feel productive and like I'm starting my day on the right foot, but you can do it whenever it works for you and move your body in a way that feels good and isn't a punishment or makes you feel like you have to. Actually do it for yourself, and this can be anything. For me, it's yoga because I really value that mind-body spiritual connection, and I find that I get it through that, and it's something that I can look forward to and that grounds me. So I hope you can find something like that too, because it's really helped me. Another thing is just taking care of yourself, and it can be little things like brushing your hair, taking a nice hot shower, doing your skincare routine, and not in the whole buying into, I have to use these products in order to look this way or feel this way, but actually just doing things for yourself and taking care of your body and giving yourself little bits of love. It may not seem like it, but a simple act of brushing your hair or hydrating your body can be little acts of self-love that can help you in your mental health throughout your day. And really the number one big thing that I did that's made such a big difference to my mental health is that I got a therapist. So I want to say a big thank you to BetterHelp for sponsoring this video. I really just had a breakdown at the beginning of the school year and realized that it was time for me to get a regular therapist. And luckily BetterHelp is great and will assess your needs and match you with your own licensed professional therapist, and you can start talking to them within 48 hours. So it's not a crisis line or self-help or anything, it's like actual professional therapy done online, so you can do it from anywhere. And there's a therapist for everyone. They have over 20,000 people in their network, and it's available to people worldwide. You can log into your account anytime and send a message to your therapist, so you can always be in contact with them, which is really great and something I really love. And you get timely responses from them. You can schedule weekly video or phone sessions. I do weekly video sessions with mine, which I love. And BetterHelp really wants to make sure that you get matched to your perfect therapist. So they have this questionnaire that you'll do, and it'll help match you so that you can fill out things like your personal information and what you really want from your therapy experience. And it's so much more affordable than traditional offline therapy. And they also have financial aid because they just really want you to get connected to somebody right away. So I'm so excited to be able to offer a special discount just for you guys, because as you know, I really believe that everyone should have a therapist, and BetterHelp is making that possible for everyone. So for my audience, if you guys want 10% off your first month, you can go to betterhelp.com/Sienna. So that's better, H-E-L-P. And you can join me and over a million other people in their network who are taking charge of their mental health and really putting themselves first. So I want that for you guys.
When it's good to celebrate it, you know?
Yeah. Yay, progress.
Yeah. Wow, it's always such a gift. And I'll see you in 2 weeks.
Thank you.
Bye.
Just got done with therapy. I made a lot of progress, so I'm really happy with myself and proud of myself. I've been going every single week since the beginning of September, when I had my really bad PTSD attack at the beginning of like school starting. So it's amazing. That's what like finally gave me the push to actually get my therapist. I've been going every single week, been really proud of myself, doing a lot of work, having a lot of emotions come up and difficult things, but also talking through so much stuff in my life and reframing things and just talking about different things in my life and reframing them in different ways, and having a lot of like thinking about ways that I can manage my anxiety going forward and stuff like that. And yeah, I had a really, really great session. And I wake up and I have my little morning routine, and I told my therapist that I've been making a lot of strides and feeling safe and cultivating, you know, this space in the morning where I wake up and I do the crossword and I make myself coffee and I light some candles and I just have a moment for myself. And you know, it's a small thing, but it's been helping me so much, and I've done it every single day this week. And you know, she started cheering, so it was, you know, it's a good thing, little wins. That's been really, really helping me, and it's what makes me feel really safe and calms my anxiety first thing in the morning. So yeah, I'm really proud of myself, making good progress. Oh gosh, now I'm getting emotional. Like, I like never cry in front of her either. I'm like really bad at crying in front of therapists and like other people. Yeah. Good job, Sienna. You got this. And to everyone else out there, you got this too. Therapy works wonders. Everyone should have a therapist. I truly believe that. So yeah, high five. You got this.
So something that's actually really been helping my mental health is first thing in the morning, just getting up and taking time for myself. So sometimes that's reading a few pages of a book, or actually something that my aunt in London got me into, and also which is a routine that I do with my parents at home, is I'll wake up and first thing I'll do the New York Times crossword and the word scramble puzzle. And I don't know, something about this, just using my brain first thing in the morning, it just really calms me down in my anxiety, and it just like helps me kind of like wake my brain up in the morning and get going. And it's just something I look forward to. It makes me like feel accomplished first thing to just do something fun that's low stress. So yeah, that's a little routine that I've kept for a while. So whether it's the crossword or reading, or it's something else entirely different for you guys, just having something first thing in the morning. And I actually stick to this. It's something I look forward to, and something really small that doesn't take up too much time, but that just really grounds my day. And a lot of habits I will definitely not stick to first thing in the morning, like meditation's really tough for me to do, but actually just doing this is something that's really worked for me. You guys know I make my bed every morning without fail, but it actually is just, you know, a little thing that can ground you first thing in the morning, and you can feel accomplished just by doing this one little thing. So having something small that you do first thing just to feel accomplished and like, hey, like, even if it's a bad day, even if, you know, my anxiety isn't great today, if I do this one little thing, you know, that's accomplishment, that's success. So that's really helped me. And also just cleaning up your space, I think, you know, especially when our mental health is bad, it's so easy to let things in our life go, like our laundry and our space, our rooms become messy, our closet becomes messy, and, you know, a messy space really just can add to all of that stress and may not feel like it in the moment, but actually cleaning up and organizing your life and your space can help you feel more settled and more calm in your mind. And it's really helped me just to feel like even if inside everything isn't going well, at least externally things are put together and organized, and it creates like a little safe space for you. You know, when your space is decluttered and nice, you will inherently feel good in it as well. Thank you. the last little tip I have is to take care of something other than yourself. Sometimes it's so hard to show ourselves love, but if we have something small like a pet or even a plant or two, and just taking care of them and having something small that you show love to and that is a responsibility and you take care of can actually make you feel really good about yourself and be better at showing yourself that same kindness that you show other things. So yeah, I hope this video helped you in some small way, because these are all the things that have been helping me. And you know what? We got this, guys. We're in it together. Sending all the love in the world.